In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create 10 different text animations in After Effects. Let's get to it. Before we begin, I want to quickly mention that all compositions created are in 1920 by 1080, 30 frames per second. I've already added the same text to all compositions. Here are the character settings, and also the paragraph is set to center text. Now let's begin with the first example, that is the smooth position. For this, we're going to expand the settings of the text, click the animate button, select position, then click the add button, property opacity. Now we need to set the starting values for the animation, and in this example we want to move the text down by increasing the second position value to 100, then also set opacity to 0, then expand range selector 1, create a keyframe for offset by clicking on a stopwatch icon and set the value to negative 100 at the beginning of the layer, then go 1 second forward and set offset to positive 100%, then expand advanced, set shape to be ramp up, then set ease high to 50% and ease low to 100%. And before we do the preview, let's enable motion blur scroll all the way up. If you don't see these settings, toggle switch the mode down here and then check this icon to add motion blur to the text. And here's a smooth position animation. Now let's move to the next example, that is a smooth scale. So again, we expand the settings, we click the animate button, and this time we select scale. Then set scale to 0%, expand range selector 1, create a keyframe for offset, set it to negative 100 at the beginning of the layer, go 1 second forward, set it to positive 100, then expand advanced, set shape to ramp up, and again, ease high 50%, ease low 100%. Don't forget to add motion blur by checking this icon, and here's a smooth scale up animation. Next example is the flicker. Again, we expand the settings, we click the animate button, and this time we select opacity. Then set opacity to 0%, expand range selector 1, then go into advanced, set smoothness all the way to 0, also enable a randomize order, and create a keyframe for random seed by clicking on the stopwatch icon, and then for the start as well at 0 at the beginning of the layer. Then we select the layer and press U on the keyboard to isolate the keyframes that we just created, then go 1 second forward, increase the start to 100%, and random seed to 50. We don't need motion blur for this, so here's our flicker animation. Next example is the smooth fade. Again, we expand the settings, we click the animate button and select opacity. Then we set opacity to 0%, we expand the range selector 1, we create keyframe for offset, set it to negative 100, then go 1 second forward, set it to positive 100, then go into advanced, set shape to ramp up, then ease high 25%, ease low 25%, and here we have a smooth fade animation. The next one is the typewriter. So for this, we don't expand anything, we open effects and presets, and we search for typewriter. Then drag the typewriter preset onto the text layer and select the text layer and press U on the keyboard to see the keyframes. Now make sure you move the first keyframe to the beginning of the layer and then the second keyframe to the point where you want the animation to end. And for me, that is 1 second. And here we have the typewriter animation. The next one is the pop-up. So for this, we need to select the text layer and move the anchor point into the center of the text layer. The way we do that is by holding Control or Command if you're in the Mac, then double click on the pan behind tool. That should center the anchor point. Then we select the text layer and press S on the keyboard to bring up the scale property. Let's create a keyframe for scale and set the value to 0% at the beginning of the layer, then go 3 or 4 frames forward, 1, 2, 3, 4, then set scale to 125, then move another 3 or 4 frames forward, 1, 2, 3, 4, and set scale back to 100%. Don't forget to add motion blur by checking this icon. And here we have the pop-up effect. This is very popular to use on subtitle animations, just keep that in mind. Next, we have the masking position. So for this, we're going to expand the settings, animate button, and add position. Now, before we adjust any values, let's go up to the tools bar and select the rectangle tool. Then make sure the text there is selected and highlighted, and we're going to click and drag to create a mask covering the top half of the composition and also the text. And make sure you move the edge of the mask really close to the text, just leave some space in between the two. Then let's increase the second position value to move the text down outside of the mask to the point that it's not visible. Then create a keyframe for position. Then move 1 second forward and set position back to 0. Now drag and select these two keyframes, right click any of them, keyframe assistant, easy ease, or you can press F9 as the shortcut. Now all the keyframes are selected, go into the graph editor by clicking here, then right click, make sure edit speed graph is checked. Now select the second point, you will see the yellow handles. Let's drag the second yellow handle all the way to the left to create this graph. Then exit the graph editor, and before we preview, let's enable motion blur by checking this icon. And here we have a smooth masking animation. The next one is the snappy position. So for this, we expand the settings, we go to animate, position, then add button, property opacity, then add button again, property tracking. Now let's move the text down by increasing the second value to 100. Now before we adjust opacity, let's decrease the tracking amount to make the letters overlap on top of each other. So negative 110 works. Then set opacity to 0, then open range selector 1, create a keyframe for start at 0%, then go 1 second forward, set start to 100%, then drag and select the keyframes, press F9 to easily ease them, go into the graph editor again, select the second point, drag its handle all the way to the left, and then the second point, drag it to the right almost all the way until influence is about 80%, exit the graph editor, enable motion blur, and here's our snappy position animation. The next one is the flip or flipping effect, so expand the settings of the text, click the animate button, enable pair character 3D, then animate button again and select rotation, then add button property opacity, now set Y rotation to negative 90 degrees, then set opacity to 0, then expand range selector 1, create a keyframe for offset, set it to negative 100, 1 second forward, positive 100, then expand advanced, set shape to ramp up, ease high, 50%, ease low, 100%. Don't forget to enable motion blur. And here we have the flipping text animation. Then lastly, we have the cinematic blur. For this, we're going to expand the settings, animate, blur, then add button property opacity, then increase blur to 200, then set opacity to 0. Open range selector 1, create keyframe for offset, set it to negative 100, 1 second forward, positive 100, expand advanced, set shape to ramp up, leave ease high and ease low at 0%, just make sure you enable a randomize order. And here we have the cinematic blur animation. And that was 10 different text animations in one video. Thank you guys for watching.